this week on Destinations.
We're only a couple of hours into our hike, and already it's absolutely gorgeous. In just a little bit, we're going to be at the base of the mountain, and we're going to start our climb up. So come on, let's go.
We're going to be speaking with a man who's a veteran of World Cup soccer, European leagues, won a national title. But he doesn't play for France, doesn't play for Brazil, doesn't play for Germany or the United Kingdom. I wonder what team he does play for.
Welcome to Destinations. I'm Kane Farabaugh.
And I'm Army Sergeant Rob Gwin, and we're here at the General Patton Hotel in Garmisch, Germany.
And even though we've been here in Garmisch during a weekend of heavy flooding in the state of Bavaria, that didn't stop Rob and our fearless cameraman Patrick from climbing a mountain.
Well, that's right, Kane, but it wasn't just any mountain. It was the highest point in Germany. It was the Zugspitze. And it all started 2 days ago when we hooked up with our friends at AFRC Outdoor Rec at the Habsburg Lodge right here in Garmisch, Germany for a two-day trek up that mountain. We started off on foot from Outdoor Rec's Habsburg Lodge. That's the white building in the background, behind the cows. Behind the cows. All right, enough with the cows already. There were 10 of us in our group, and though the pace wasn't really that hard, my cameraman and I seemed to lag behind right from the start. Actually, we stopped to shoot some video of, you guessed it, those cows. And thankfully, our guide stayed with us to make sure we didn't get lost. Our trip has taken us through the scenic Parknot Gorge. We're only a couple of hours into our hike, and already it's absolutely gorgeous. In just a little bit, we're going to be at the base of the mountain, and we're going to start our climb up. So come on, let's go.
Walking through the basin of the gorge is considered to be one of the most scenic hikes in Bavaria, and with good reason. You can walk through the most scenic part of the Parknot in an afternoon. So, if a two-day hike up the Zugspitze doesn't fit into your schedule, the folks at AFRC Outdoor Rec also offer one-day hikes through this incredible scenery. Once you're inside the deepest part of the gorge, the roar of the river is awesome. And the natural beauty is amazing.
This hike through our friends at AFRC at Garmisch, and this particular trail that we're on allows for plenty of places to stop, relax, and enjoy the scenery. Right now, though, it's time for a little lunch.
What gets up with those guys climbing up the mountain later on in the show? Right now, what we want to do is take some time out and show you many other things to do here at the Armed Forces Recreation Center in Garmisch. And one of those things is strapping on and jumping off.
Actually, we're getting ready to jump down a mountain, which sounds like a crazy thing. Well, I've actually been coming here to Garmisch here for about 20 years, and usually it's for winter sports. But, of course, we found out that that they have a lot of summer programs here, too, so I wanted to take advantage of it. And they keep you moving at a good pace, so you're not sitting around bored all the time, and you're teaching a lot of the fundamentals so that you're safe the whole time. They take you up gradually, so, you know, of course, the fear factor, it's not a big shock to you when you finally get up to those levels. It's reasonably priced. It's $260 for 4 days, so that's good. And if you want to go on longer and actually get your full certificate, your full license, I guess you would call it here in Germany, I think it's going to cost more. But for 4 days of doing this, I think it's worth it. Best view in town.
None of us will ever forget this day, yet we go forward to defend freedom and all that is good and just in our world.
Even though it was a gorgeous, beautiful day, it had this somber strangeness to it.
The scene here in Somerset County, Pennsylvania is still very busy tonight.
Miss out. Visit School Aid Services to check out what they offer.
LA just trying to cause confusion right now in the penalty area with that movement.
We're here today talking with a soccer legend in his own right. Many people may not know exactly who he is, but we're hoping to take care of that today on Destinations. Paul Caligiuri.
Yes.
Welcome to the program.
Great to be here. Thank you.
First of all, you're a soccer player, obviously, while we're talking to you this morning. Good year for American soccer?
Oh, yeah.
You're excited?
It was incredible that the United States reached the quarterfinals of the World Cup. No one expected them to get that far, and it just shows you that soccer's really growing in the United States.
Now, this isn't the first year that soccer has been good for the United States, and you were a part of history making for America getting into the World Cup back in 1990. You fired what was, you know, considered now the shot heard round the world, put the Americans in the World Cup for the first time in 40 years. Exciting time for you personally?
Well, back then, soccer wasn't really popular in the United States, and for me to be involved in really the growth of the sport and getting it started to participate in the World Cup. And looking back at my participation in 1990 and 1994, to see how far we've come today is just really exciting.
Now, what's interesting, though, is, soccer, American soccer could have gone, it seems like we reached a peak and could have gone either way, really, because in 90, we lost to the Italians, who went on to win the bronze, mm-hmm. and only by, I think it was one goal, and they were the host that year, so right. It was a pretty tough match.
One of the top favorites, definitely.
And then in 94, we lost to the champions, who the Brazilians went on to win the championship. So you could say that maybe if we hadn't had such high opposition right off the bat, who knows, we could have gone even deeper.
Yeah. Well, the World Cup, you have the best teams, period. So really, there's not an easy opponent. But yeah, those World Cups, we definitely faced the most difficult opponent, and even this time, Germany reached the final. They beat the United States 1-0, but the United States played better than Germany, without a doubt. And I think that the German coach, Rudi Völler, mentioned that, saying that we lost to a better team today, or we beat a better team today.
Now, in your World Cup action, obviously, you get to play against a lot of international teams, some of the best, well, obviously the best from around the world. That's not new to you, though, right? Because you played one of the first Americans to come over to Germany to play in the Bundesliga, was it?
Yes, I played in the Bundesliga. I played 6 years total in Germany. And that was prior to Major League Soccer being established. But once we created our league in 1995, I actually returned back and played six seasons for the Los Angeles Galaxy of Major League Soccer. So now we see that soccer is not only growing on the international level with the World Cup teams, the Olympic teams that we continue to build, both on the women's and the men's level, we see that we have a professional league established, which is really creating a lot of new talent.
Now, there was a lot that came out in this World Cup about how Americans haven't really caught on to soccer yet. I wanted to kind of get your feelings. What is it about the sport that you think maybe people don't catch on to or they don't understand that's keeping them away?
Well, I think that soccer is not a spectator sport necessarily in the United States. When you start to compare it to football or baseball and sports of that elite, but I think that soccer is growing. It offers more scholarships for men and women to go to college than any other sport. And the evolution of soccer, basically when I was in high school, soccer wasn't cool, so to say, to play. But now if you're a high school soccer player, you're looked at as one of the cool people on campus. And I think that soccer is growing. It's just a matter of evolution and time.
And speaking of campus, I think, me personally, I think one of the things that's going to draw people into soccer is, sure, the being on the world stage helps a lot, but now you're going to be the head coach at Cal Poly in Pomona, California. Mm-hmm. I really think that that's what's going to draw the youth into soccer, is people like you who are excited about the game already, bringing your enthusiasm out there to the field, instilling that in the young people and bringing them up from the get-go.
Well, I just hope I can coach now. Yeah. One thing's getting the job, the other thing's keeping it. So. Now, I'm really excited. I'll be coaching at Cal Poly Pomona in Southern California, and I've taken on the big task of coaching both the men's and the women's soccer program. But I also am able to reach out to the youth level and develop other like camps and clinics and other programs. And that's what really brings me to Europe, is I'm able to go out to the Air Force bases, seven of them, and do clinics and things like that for not only the kids that are playing soccer, but also for the parent coaches or anybody that wants to become interactively involved. And it's just a great opportunity for a person who's played on the world level and played in different countries and toured really the world in different ways to now reach, give back and come back to the Europe and really bring soccer to these places where they really haven't had the opportunity to experience the things I have.
All right, Paul Caligiuri, thanks for joining us here on Destinations.
Thank you.
Some professional training can be pretty boring, filled with dull lectures. But not MWR training. Looking for exciting, interactive training? Want to enhance your job expertise and performance? Become competitive for promotions and raises? MWR Training and Development Europe provides hands-on training in all areas of MWR. For more details, check out our website.
Booking official U.S. Army Europe or leisure travel has never been so easy. Log on to www.satotravel.com/user and book your vacation or official travel via the net. No waiting, no lines. When there's a mission to accomplish, your time is essential. www.satotravel.com/user allows you to reserve leisure or official travel from anywhere in Europe 24 hours a day.
The first 2 years of your child's life is the optimum time for language development. Reading to your child for 15 minutes a day is a great way to develop your child's language skills.
Standing a little more than 10,000 feet above sea level, the Zugspitze is the highest peak in Germany. And if you ride one of the cable cars or tram lines that dot the sides of the mountain, you can reach the top in a matter of minutes. But if you hike it, well, it can take a couple of days. And so an overnight rest stop after a full day on the trails is just what my foot doctor ordered. Our stopover was part of the two-day package offered by AFRC Outdoor Rec and included dinner and breakfast the next morning. As well as a little homespun entertainment. About 8:30 in the morning on day two of our climb to the top of the Zugspitze, and it's really wet and rainy out here this morning. We've traveled about 10 miles already. We've got about 5 miles left to go to the top. And that last 5 miles was no walk in the park. It seemed that with every step we took, it just got colder and wetter.
So what do you think of the climb so far?
So far it's great.
Is it what you expected?
Wetter.
Really?
A little bit wetter.
What's been the toughest part?
Keeping up with these guys.
Yeah. What's the best part?
The beer.
All right, great.
Actually, at that point, I was kind of hoping for some coffee or hot chocolate. Little did I know, the hardest part was yet to come.
You done this kind of thing before?
No, nothing this serious, just ropes marching.
What's the best part for you so far?
The views, just sitting around at the table drinking beer and chewing the fat with the guys.
Is it what you expected? Tougher?
More than I expected in terms of scenery and beauty. Tougher, I think we'll find out in the next couple of hours.
Don't trust anybody.
What's been the most challenging?
Learning about what's ahead on today and just kind of getting myself mentally prepared. Yeah.
What was ahead was both immense and amazing.
Okay, we're at the base of the first hard part of our trek up to the top of the Zugspitze. The scenery here is absolutely spectacular. I've only ever seen views like this in the movies. As you can see, it's pretty vertical. It's gonna take us a couple hours to get up there, but we're not stopping now.
Though I really wanted to stop, but I didn't. I just kept putting one foot in front of the other and thinking to myself two simple thoughts. Coffee, warm bed. Oh yeah, and I also thought, just wait till I get my hands on that Kane Farabaugh. Hey, Rob, he says, I have a great idea for destinations. Why don't you climb the Zugspitze? It'll be fun. Actually, it was fun, and I'd recommend this trip to any avid hiker. For more information on how you can hike to the top of Germany's highest peak, just log on to the web at www.afrceurope.com. Unfortunately, the weather did our camera in before we got to the peak, but we did get there, and Kane was waiting to greet us. He took a cable car to the top. But who knows? Maybe he'll walk back down.
Actually, Rob, I'm not going to go all the way down the mountain. I'll wait for you right here on the observation deck where the weather is lovely. That about wraps it up for us this week on Destinations. If you like what you see and you've got a story idea near you and you want us to come cover a story, just drop us an email. That email address is destinations@afn.frankfurt.army.mil. We'd love to hear from you, and it's also a great way to let us know what you think about the show. From the roof of the world here in Germany, I'm Kane Farabaugh, and I'm joined with
Army Sergeant Rob Gwin, and I want to say thanks to our friends at AFRC at Garmisch for helping us get to the top of the Zugspitze this week.
Rob's a little wet.
Yeah, and I'm cold, so can we go?
Thanks for joining us this week. We'll see you next time.
We'll see you next time.
Tonight.